Good evening. The Monmouth Hawks visit the Delaware Blue Hens, and I'm Richie Rasper alongside Jack Roberts here to bring you the second game. Jack, what did you see from the Monmouth Delaware game in the first game of the doubleheader?
In the first game, I saw Monmouth really do a good job of putting the ball in play. They were able to stay alive once they got two strikes on them. They were able to foul off pitches and keep at bats going, which really put a lot of stress on Carolyn Szymanski, the pitcher for Delaware, to stay accurate and stay on her game. And from Delaware, I just saw a lack of offense. They really struggled to get the ball in play, and I think that goes without saying that Amanda Riley, the pitcher for the Monmouth team, did a great job of shutting down the Blue Hens hitters, really staying ahead in the count, not falling behind, really.
There wasn't too much offensive productivity from either team in that one, but Monmouth able to squeeze out the win 3-1 over Delaware as we get ready to take on the second game of the doubleheader. We see Kirsten Coffman on the mound. Coffman throws the first one in for a strike. 0-1 the count. This is Coffman's 18th appearance, her 12th start. She has over 69 innings pitched. As you see that one fouled down the third base line. She's been a workhorse here for the Delaware Blue Hens so far this season.
Yes, she has. She's been carrying the brunt of this pitching staff, pitching over 20 more innings than Szymanski. And she's been doing a good job of keeping her strikeout to walks ratio about 3-1 strikeouts to walks. And she's only allowed hitters to average 267 against her. Count is now evened up 2-2 with zero outs in the top of the first.
Emma Hill stands in for Monmouth. Gets one over to the third baseman. Fires over to first for the out was Lisa Stashevitz. One gone here in the top of the first. The Blue Hens against the Hawks.
Left fielder number 8, Chloe Hoare.
Chloe Hoare stands in here for the Hawks against Kirsten Coffman. Some great defense from her in the earlier game. Sliding play out in left field as she takes one inside there for a ball, even in the count at 1-1.
She also had two balls hit over her head that she had the track back. She did a great job catching both of those on the warning track.
Very active in the first game. Hopefully the Hens keep her active again here in the second game, but maybe squeezing some through the holes out there in the outfield.
Yeah, the Hens just really struggled to catch a break, having most of the play. I mean, they made solid contact. It was just Monmouth defense was really doing a good job of patrolling the outfield.
And I'm sure head coach John Seneca was talking with the team in between games and telling them just that, to try and create more opportunities for the team to drive some runs in, as you see a foul ball there.
I really would not be surprised to see Delaware play a little more small ball coming into this game, because they were only able to scrounge up about one run. And so maybe some bunts and moving runners into scoring position will help them be more productive this second game.
Chloe Hoare stands in the count 2-2 against Kirsten Coffman, who fires one. Hoare drills one right back to the shortstop, Leanna Gerhart, unable to make a play, which allows Hoare to get to first safely. First runner on for Monmouth here in the second game.
Shortstop, number 11, Rachel Southparker.
Monmouth head coach Shannon Salzberg, when we were talking to her before the game, she said that the keys to success for them today were going to be the offense and defense both playing aggressive. The offense just needs to jump out and score runs, and the defense needs to be playing aggressive in the field, but the pitching needs to be smart. They need to be able to keep the ball on the ground and not allow Delaware to put any over the fence.
Ball lofted to the third baseman. Lisa Stashevitz able to put one away for the second out of the inning. Kirsten Coffman so far doing pretty well on the mound and not allowing Monmouth to get a hold of anything too much so far in this first inning. Fires one over for a strike. Doing a great job of getting ahead in counts so far as well. Reyes takes another one over the middle of the plate. Strike two with two outs and a runner on first.
Kaufman's doing a nice job of staying ahead in the counts and really putting the batters on a defensive swing versus letting them just take a rip.
Kaufman looks like she was trying to waste one outside and gets Reyes swinging to end the inning.
Stay connected with the Blue Hens on all social media outlets. Follow at UD Blue Hens on Twitter for score updates, news, and everything Delaware sports. Check out at Hens All Access to see what it takes behind the scenes to bring you Delaware athletics. Interact with the University of Delaware Fightin' Blue Hens on Facebook to get to know the athletes and hear about events offered to Blue Hens fans. And take a look at UD Blue Hens on Instagram for game times, game finals, along with throwbacks of old Hens and promos for future Hens.
And a goal! It's Delgado with his second.
Delaware 3, 1-2-3.
Delaware!
Looks like the shot to that one's in as well.
And as the Blue Hens sent Kirsten Coffman to the mound, the Monmouth Hawks send Sydney Underhill to the mound to face the Blue Hens. What do you know about her, Jack?
Underhill has a 2.55 ERA. She's 7-6, and she's appeared in 16 games this season. She does have one complete game as well as one save, showing versatility. And she's logged 60 innings this year. So she's been the main workhorse for this Monmouth team. And I think it's going to be important for her to stay ahead of these Delaware hitters because she's walked 23 and struck out 20. So control might be a bit of an issue getting into the later innings this game.
First pitch from Underhill. A little inside for a ball against Leanna Gearhart. Pretty good game for Gearhart last in the first game, offensively and defensively. Able to get some production on both sides.
Yeah, it's going to be important for Gearhart to get on base because she has 14 steals this season on 17 attempts. So she's been a very big deal on the base paths as she lays down a bunt that goes foul.
Looked like a beautiful bunt there, but just enough movement on it to drift over the white line there. The nicely fresh chalked white lines that we have after the layover in between games. Gearhart back up to bat with the 1-2 count. Swung on right back to the mound, but over to first in time was Schatzbarger making a play.
That was a bang-bang play.
Personally, I would hate to be one of the umpires because those close calls, I don't think my eyes work very well to be able to catch that action like that.
I do not have the 20/20 vision to be making those decisions.
Exactly. But we can see that Gabby Klecko steps in to the box for the Blue Hens.
Fouls one off her foot there.
Underhill is staying true to what head coach Shannon Salzberg mentioned before the game. Very aggressive in attacking hitters, as you saw there. Leaving the ball able to be hit, but she is trusting in her fielders to make plays, as you saw Chloe Howarth out there making a play yet again for Monmouth. That brings up Anna Steinmetz batting third for your Blue Hens. Underhill fires one outside for ball one. The 1-0 pitch, a little low for a ball, brings the count to 2-0. Third one just a bit outside. Ball three, staying patient in there is Steinmetz.
Steinmetz didn't have that great of a first game, so we're looking for her to bounce back and really be productive in this second game as she gets on for, that was ball four, she walks. And that brings up Mariah Kondravi, who did have a productive first game, logging one of the four hits, and I believe she had a walk in that game too, reaching base 2 out of 4 times.
Hopefully Kondravi can step in and advance the runners and get herself on base as well as she dribbles one back to the second baseman for the easy out to end the inning. Blue Hens were unable to get anything going in the bottom of the first, but we'll be back right after this with the top of the second.
Welcome. We have 3 Chevys here.
All right.
I want you to place this award on the podium next to the vehicle that you think was ranked highest in initial quality by J.D. Power.
Can I look around at them?
Highest ranking in initial quality.
It's got to be this one.
This is it.
You are wrong.
Really?
Actually, it's all 3.
You tricked me.
J.D. Power ranked the Chevy Malibu, Silverado Half Ton, and Equinox highest in initial quality in their segments.
That's impressive.
I'm very surprised.
I am. I'm very surprised. Chevy hit 3 home runs.
You can now watch all Hens All Access content on any of your devices. Whether you're at the store on your phone or on the couch with your iPad or laptop, Hens All Access live and on-demand content is just a touch away. Not only will live games be available on your mobile devices, they'll also be available in high definition. Best of all, you don't even need an app. Just click over to BlueHens.com on your device and take the Hens anywhere you go.
Welcome back. We're here in the top of the second inning where Monmouth is facing your home, Delaware Blue Hens. On the mound for the Blue Hens is Kirsten Coffman. Stepping into the batter's box is Ashlyn Umiyamaka. Umiyamaka dribbles one third base side. Able to be handled there by Lisa Stachewicz, who fires over to Steinmetz at first.
Designated player, number 13, Jill Freeze.
Stepping in for Monmouth is Jill Freeze. First pitch over for a strike.
Jill Freeze is hitting .375 on the season with an on-base percentage at .516. Looking to get something going, but she falls behind 0-2. So now Coffman is in control.
A huge hack there from Jill Freeze, trying to get a little production going. Coffman sneaks one over the outside of the plate there to end Freeze's chances. She froze Freeze, if you will.
Your wordplay is ridiculous.
For the second out in the inning. We see Wieserich, Nicole Wieserich, come up to bat for Monmouth. Coffman fires one over for a strike. Kirsten Coffman is getting ahead of batters early so far. Going right at the strike zone, not really afraid of too much as it seems.
She's doing a great job of staying ahead. Not giving the batters a chance to really load up and take a full cut.
Wieserich swung on big time and missed, forcing the count to 1-2. Coffman again with a few pitches to play around with. She winds and fires and gets Wieserich swinging to end the inning. A very fast pace here for Delaware Monmouth as we head into the bottom of the second.
Chevy's here.
All right.
I want you to place this award on the podium next to the vehicle that you think was ranked highest in initial quality by J.D. Power. Mm.
Can I look around at them?
Sure.
Highest ranking in initial quality.
It's got to be this one.
This is it.
You are wrong.
Really?
Actually, it's all three.
You tricked me.
J.D. Power ranked the Chevy Malibu, Silverado Half Ton, and Equinox highest in initial quality in their segments.
That's impressive.
I'm very surprised.
I am. I'm very surprised. Debbie hit three home runs.
Beautiful look there at the American flag waving in the wind here in Newark, Delaware, as the Blue Hens take on the Monmouth Hawks. Lisa Stashevitz steps in for the Hens, takes ball one as Sydney Underhill remains on the mound for Monmouth. Stashevitz hits one hard back to the third baseman, Umi Amaka, who makes a play over to Reyes at first to get the first out of the inning.
Stasevitz really connected on that one, but Umi Amaka was just ready for that ball.
Left fielder number three, Shelby Jones.
Shelby Jones readies for the Blue Hens, hoping to get some production against the lefty from Monmouth. Takes one there for a strike. 0-1 the count. Second one, just a bit outside for a ball. 1-1 the count with one out. Bottom of the second inning.
Shelby Jones fouls that one off to the left side. Way out in front, she falls behind 1-2 in the count with one out in the bottom of the second.
Underhill readies and fires. Shelby Jones fouls one off the third base line. Looked close there.
Just
close
call.
Just snuck a little bit left. Count remains at 1-2. Jones swings and lofts one just over the shortstop's head. Able to get into first safely without any problems.
That was the first hit of the game for the Hens. And looking to get something started in the bottom of the second.
Catcher number 13, Danielle Wissinger.
That'll bring up Danielle Wissinger. Trying to keep this going for the Hens. She stands in. Underhill throws. for ball one. 1-0 the count.
Wissinger is batting 250 on the season. And she's looking to do some damage here. Trying to at least move the runner over at first in the scoring position.
Takes another one there for ball two. Underhill throws again. Gets one over for a strike. 2-1 the count as Wissinger. Trying to make something happen here for the Blue Hens. Lined right back to Underhill. Makes a tip off of the glove back to Schatzbarger, who turns two with Wieserich and Reyes to end the inning. And
we have three Chevys here.
All right.
I want you to place this award on the podium next to the vehicle that you think was ranked highest in initial quality by J.D. Power. Hmm.
Can I look around at them?
Sure.
Highest ranking in initial quality.
It's got to be this one.
This is it.
You are wrong.
Really?
Actually, it's all three.
You tricked me.
J.D. Power ranked the Chevy Malibu, Silverado Half Ton, and Equinox highest in initial quality in their segments.
That's impressive.
I'm very surprised.
I am. I'm very surprised. Chevy hit three home runs.
Welcome back to this Hens All Access broadcast of softball. This is game two. Unfortunately, game one went the way of Monmouth as they won 3-1. But so far this game, the second game of the doubleheader, it's been moving pretty quickly for both teams. Neither team able to get much production so far, which has been making the game run pretty smoothly so far.
Leading off this inning, we have Brooke Redman, who is getting her first at-bat on the day. Looking to get things started here for the Hawks.
Redman swung on and missed for strike one. Coffman really offering some good pitches so far, catching the Monmouth batter's eye and really forcing them to swing at some pitches that maybe they wouldn't want to swing out normally, as you see another foul ball, strike two.
She started a great amount of these counts, 0-2, 0-1, and it really helps her cause to put these batters in a defensive mood where they're not able to.
As you see another one there, just absolutely blown by Redman.
She's just straight up dealing.
Coffman able to strike Redman out, brings up Katie Barron for Monmouth. Coffman winds and fires.
Barron
gets a lot of that one. But Shelby Jones able to make a play on the warning track, running into the wall for the first out, or the second out, excuse me, of the inning.
Coffman getting some help from her defense there. Really good job tracking that ball in the outfield by Shelby Jones.
Off the bat, I wasn't sure if that one was going to stay in or not, but
it had the height.
Shelby Jones knows more than me, and she was able to make a play on that one. Coffman throws the first one. Deflected foul by Emma Hill. Counts 0-1 here, two outs in the top of the third.
Hill, if she gets on base, she is a speed demon, going 11 for 11 with stolen bases and stolen base attempts. So the Blue Hens really need to focus on not letting her get on the bases.
Coffman throws one a little inside there for a ball. And you mentioned the speed of Emma Hill. You can just see from the stance that she has up at the plate, she's looking to slap the ball and get down the line as fast as she can as she takes strike two there from Coffman. Counts 1-2. Coffman offers another one that's popped up right to Lisa Stashevitz over at third to end the inning, and we'll be right back with the bottom of the third after this.
Stay connected with the Blue Hens on all social media outlets. Follow at UD Blue Hens on Twitter for score updates, news, and everything Delaware sports. Check out at Hens All Access to see what it takes behind the scenes to bring you Delaware athletics. Interact with the University of Delaware Fightin' Blue Hens on Facebook to get to know the athletes and hear about events offered to Blue Hens fans. And take a look at UD Blue Hens on Instagram for game times, game finals, along with throwbacks of old Hens and promos for future Hens.
And a goal, it's Delgado with his second.
Sydney Underhill for Monmouth is set to face Alicia Delator, Hannah George, and Leanna Gearhart for the Blue Hens. Leading off is Delator. Underhill sets and throws. Over for a strike. 0-1 the count.
Delator, this is her first at bat today. Looking to jumpstart this Blue Hen offense.
They will make a play for the first of the inning. You see Hannah George getting ready for her at bat. One and one the count. We apologize for the technical difficulties we're having. As George fires one into right field under the glove of Reyes, able to reach safely at first base.
We now have the top of the lineup, starting off with Leanne Gearhart, who really did have a pretty good first game, so she's looking to
11,
continue that streak and move Hannah George into scoring position.
Gearhart fires one of the second basemen looking to turn two, but the speed of Gearhart disrupts the double play that Monmouth was trying to turn there.
Gabby Klecko coming up for her second at bat on this game. And hopefully just trying to look to put the ball into play and try to let the Monmouth defense make the move.
Gearhart takes off for second again. She did that a few times in the first game and continues the aggressiveness here in the second game, able to reach second with a throw a little bit off the mark from Redmond.
I believe that's her 16th steal on the season.
Klecko swung on and missed, bringing the count even at 1-1. With two outs here, Klecko just looking to make any contact she can, trying to get it through the infield, hoping to get the speedy legs of Gearhart to get moving and get her across the plate, but unfortunately she grounds out to end the inning. And with that, we'll be right back after this.
Test drive at Anchor
Welcome. We have three Chevys here.
All right.
I want you to place this award on the podium next to the vehicle that you think was ranked highest in initial quality by J.D. Power. Hmm.
Can I look around at them?
Sure.
Highest ranking in initial quality.
It's gotta be this one.
This is it.
You are wrong.
Really?
Actually, it's all three.
You tricked me.
J.D. Power ranked the Chevy Malibu, Silverado Half Ton, and Equinox highest in initial quality in their segments.
That's impressive.
I'm very surprised.
I am. I'm very surprised. Chevy hit three home runs.
You can now watch all Hens All Access content on any of your devices. Whether you're at the store on your phone or on the couch with your iPad or laptop, Hens All Access live and on-demand content is just a touch away. Not only will live games be available on your mobile devices, they'll also be available in high definition. Best of all, you don't even need an app. Just click over to BlueHens.com on your device and take the Hens anywhere you go.
Kirsten Coffman, surrounded by her teammates on the mound as they get ready to start here at the top of the fourth inning. This game has been flying by so far. Just some great defense and great pitching leading to some struggles in both offenses here so far.
All around, it's just been a well defensive played game. Gearhart struggled.
Chloe Howarth dribbles one right back to Coffman, who fires over to Steinmetz at first for the first out of the inning. We've seen a few of those in the two games. Some little dribblers back to the mound. And the pitchers were able to make great plays so far today and fire over to first for some good plays to get out to first.
They've done a good job of converting those give me outs that are an easy play that should be converted.
Schatzbarger lines one to left field over the head of Gearhart. Reaches safely at first. That's the first solid contact we've seen from the Monmouth batter so far this game. Finally, someone was able to catch up to Kaufman's speed. As you see, Justine Reyes coming into the box for Monmouth to face Coffman, who winds and fires. Popped up behind the plate.
Stays in play, and
Wissinger able to make a play on it.
Great.
And fires to second, where Gearhart is ready to make a play and get Schatzbarger trying to take an extra base. That'll end the inning here. We'll be back with the bottom of the fourth after this. Back here for the bottom of the fourth inning. It feels like there's been a lot of breaks and not much play going on. We're just checking back for a few outs and then heading to break and checking back in for a few more outs. Just the consistency of play has been unreal so far.
These innings have been flying by. Through 3.5 innings, we've only had 3 hits, and it's really shown. I mean, the pitching from Coffman and from Underhill has really led their teams to have success so far. And great plays from their defense with that play from Wissinger, the double play, foul ball over from the catcher spot, and a throw all the way down the second to get the runner trying to advance.
That was one of the better plays that I've seen in college softball and in any softball that I've watched. Great awareness to get over and make a play, and then not only remember the runner can advance on that play, but able to force her out at second, or get her out at second there. was just great awareness all around. As you see, Steinmetz in the box for the Blue Hens, already down 0-1 in the count. As she takes one there inside for ball one to even the count.
Steinmetz, when she leads off an inning, is hitting .353 as she grounds the ball back to the pitcher, turns, fires first, get the out.
One down here in the top of the fourth. Mariah Kondravy set to bat for the Blue Hens. This part of the lineup is really where the production comes in, with really starting from the top of the lineup with Gerhardt, and then all the way down to Kondravy, Stashevitz, even straight down the lineup, there's production being had by the Blue Hens.
The meat of their lineup seems to be the 3-6 spot, where they've been driving in most of the runs that they've scored today. So we'll look for that going forward.
Kondravy fouls the first one off for strike one. Gets a hold of the second one, but pops it up to the infield as Reyes calls everyone off and makes a play for out number two. That'll bring Stashevitz up to bat. We saw her earlier in this game strike one pretty hard, but one of the infielders was able to make a play and shut down the chance that she had to start something there. Underhill fires one outside for ball one.
Yeah, Umi Amaka made a great play over at third base, having her hands down and trapping the ball and making a strong throw over to first base.
Underhill, another one. Low and away. 2-0 the count to Stashevitz. That one swung on and struck back to center field. An incredible play by Hill out there in center field. Emma Hill comes in and makes a great play on Lisa Stashevitz, who can't believe it. And with that, we will close out the fourth inning, and we'll catch you back here with the top of the fifth after this.
Welcome. We have three Chevys here.
All right.
I want you to place this award on the podium next to the vehicle that you think was ranked highest in initial quality by J.D. Power.
Can I look around at them? Is
sure.
Highest ranking in initial quality.
It's got to be this one.
This is it.
You are wrong.
Really?
Actually, it's all three.
You tricked me.
J.D. Power ranked the Chevy Malibu, Silverado Half Ton, and Equinox highest in initial quality in their segments.
That's impressive.
I'm very surprised.
I am. I'm very surprised. Chevy hit three home runs.
In between innings, we were able to talk about the pace of play and just can't really settle into an inning. So there's just so many jumps back and forth between play and breaks and play and breaks yet again. As you see, Coffman taking the mound again for the Blue Hens to face Umi Amaka from Monmouth. First one crosses the plate for a strike.
Yeah, the defense from these teams has been outstanding. That catch from Emma Hill coming in head first and diving to save a single from Stashevitz at the end of last inning. I mean, we're just seeing these defenses not make mistakes. And the pitching has been dominant through the first four innings.
Coffman fires, fouled off down the third base line. And Stashevitz was able to make a play on the Umi Amaka foul ball for out number one.
Designated player, number 13, Jill Fries.
Jill Fries coming to bat for Monmouth as Coffman looks to continue her pitching streak of just blowing balls by the batter so far. As strike one comes in, a swinging Jill Freeze takes one for a strike.
Kaufman's only allowed one hit so far and really shut down this Monmouth offense thus far.
You see strike two from Coffman there. Freeze swung on and fouled down the line, third base. Kaufman's thrown 43 pitches and 36 strikes so far this game, which is an incredible stat. And another strike there. Freeze yet again.
Kaufman is just living in the zone. Rarely missing.
That's the second strikeout looking for Freeze as she heads back to the dugout, bringing Wieserick to the plate with two outs here in the top of the fifth. Kaufman sends one over the plate. Wieserick fouls it off.
When you throw strikes at the rate that Kaufman's throwing strikes, it just forces the hitters to swing and put the ball in play or to strike out, as we've seen so far.
Kaufman fires again. Just a little bit high there for ball one. And you said Kaufman throwing as many strikes as she has. As a hitter, you see these balls coming in and they look good enough to swing at, as you see that one there too for strike two. The hitters keep swinging but just can't make contact with the ball that Kaufman's throwing.
And it's not a choice of whether it's a ball or a strike. She's pounding the zone and it's really tough for these Monmouth hitters to get anything started.
Lofted over the infield. George was there to make a play to end the inning. This game is going by very quickly, but we'll be back for the bottom of the fifth right after this.
Stay connected with the Blue Hens on all social media outlets. Follow at UD Blue Hens on Twitter for score updates, news, and everything Delaware sports. Check out at Hens All Access to see what it takes behind the scenes to bring you Delaware athletics. Interact with the University of Delaware Fightin' Blue Hens on Facebook to get to know the athletes and hear about events offered to Blue Hens fans. And take a look at UD Blue Hens on Instagram for game times, game finals, along with throwbacks of old Hens and promos for future Hens.
And a goal, it's Delgado with his second.
The pitching so far in today's matchup from Sydney Underhill from Monmouth. She's thrown four innings with two hits and one walk, facing 14 batters, but no team has scored a run so far. And on the other side, Kirsten Kaufman is just dealing for the Blue Hens. Incredible pace of play here in the second game of the doubleheader.
As we're already in the bottom of the fifth, Shelby Jones leads off the Blue Hens offense here, and she was able to get the one hit, or the one of the two hits that they've had so far, as she lines that ball down the third base for the first out of the bottom of the fifth.
She lined it right to Umi Amaka, but I'm not sure she saw the ball go right into the glove, but she just continued to run it out down the first base line, but she headed right back to the dugout right after that. And makes way for Danielle Wissinger, who swings at the first pitch. Strike one.
Wissinger with that great defensive play earlier in the game, looking to convert here and maybe bring some of that defense to the offensive side.
Is Alicia next? I can't see what this is. Second pitch swung on, drilled out to center field where Emma Hill is ready to make a play. Very quick, two outs again. Everything about this game so far has been quick.
They are just cooking. And this has really been a pitcher-dominated game.
Alicia Delator ready to step in the box for the Blue Hens to face Sydney Underhill, who winds and fires. A little bit off the plate there for ball one.
I see very little fatigue being shown by either of these pitchers. So we'll see how long they're able to keep up these.
Second pitch thrown in there for a strike. As you mentioned, not really too much weakness shown by any pitcher so far, because not many of the counts have been coming to full counts like they were in game one, as you see Delator take ball two to push the count to 2-1. Another ball thrown off the plate for ball three.
Just outside on that one.
3-1 as Delator looks to try and get on base to start something for the Hens.
She has the hitter's count.
Swung on. Squeaked through the infield between Umiyamaka and Schatzbarger as Delator able to reach first base.
That's her first hit on the day.
And with that, she makes way for Hannah George, who hopes to try and continue this little two-out rally that they're starting here. First pitch swung on, sweep through the other side, the other side of the infield, excuse me, between Wieserich and Reyes, which advances Delator to second and places George on first.
Hannah George is just killing the ball right now. She is 2-for-2 with two singles.
That brings Leanna Gearhart up to hopefully continue it for the Hens here. First pitch, a little high there for ball one. 1-0 the count here for Gearhart as she has runners on second and first with two outs. That one fouled off and out of play. 1-1 the count. Sydney Underhill readies and fires. A little high.
Gearhart is hitting .296 with runners in scoring position. So looking to convert with Delator on second base.
That one a little bit inside as Redmond calls for time so she can go talk to Sydney Underhill, the pitcher of Monmouth. And as we were talking about before, it only takes, in these kind of games, it may only take one run to decide who wins and who loses. And this chance here for the Blue Hens is looking like one of their better chances in the game so far today. Gearhart swings, hits it right to Wieserich, who's unable to make a play, which brings in Delator from second base, sending George third, and Gearhart safe at first. Brings in the first run of the game for the Blue Hens. Underhill getting a little pep speech over there from Reyes over at first.
Right fielder number 73, Gabby Klecko.
Gabby Klecko steps into the box for the Blue Hens, trying to continue this production that they've started here.
All with two outs, too.
Gearhart takes off her second yet again, and she's safe at second.
Third steal on the day. She's really a menace on the base paths, and now they have two runners in scoring positions for Gabby Klecko.
Klecko looked to bunt there. Takes one for a strike to count 1-1 with two outs. This part of the lineup, as you mentioned, is pretty big for Delaware, and with runners in scoring position on second and third, it could really cause some damage for Monmouth. Gabby Klecko dribbles one back to Underhill, who fires to first, where Reyes is there to make a play. Delaware scores one in the bottom of the fifth. We'll be back with the top of the sixth after this.
Welcome. We have three Chevys here.
All right.
I want you to place this award on the podium next to the vehicle that you think was ranked highest in initial quality by J.D. Power. Hmm.
Can I look around at them?
Sure.
Highest ranking in initial quality.
It's got to be this one.
This is it.
You are wrong.
Really?
Actually, it's all three.
You tricked me.
J.D. Power ranked the Chevy Malibu, Silverado Half Ton, and Equinox highest in initial quality in their segments.
That's impressive.
I'm very surprised.
I am. I'm very surprised. Chevy hit three home runs.
As we mentioned, the stats from Sydney Underhill before the top of the or the beginning of the last half inning, we'll go to Kirsten Kaufman's stats. 5 innings pitched, 1 hit, 5 strikeouts on 16 batters faced so far in today's game.
48 pitches through 5 innings. She is just really working through this lineup, averaging less than 10 pitches an inning.
She looks to face Brooke Redmond here, who fouls one off first pitch. Count is 0-1 here to begin the top of the sixth. Coffman winds and fires. Good over for a strike. Ahead of the count, 0-2.
Redmond falls behind. And I guarantee she's just looking to put the ball in play here. I don't know how much you can actually do when Coffman's pitching like this. As she pops it up to the shortstop, and Gearhart puts it away.
That's been how a lot of the balls have been hit so far in this second game for Monmouth. A lot of pop-ups and a lot of time for the Blue Hens fielders to get under it and make a play. Pretty easily with Kirsten Kaufman pitching.
The only solid contact that I've seen from the Monmouth Hawks this game was in their one hit by their shortstop Schatzbarger. And other than that, it's just been pop flies or weak ground balls.
Kaufman gets Katie Barron to swing the second pitch of the at bat. 1-1 with 1 out here in the top of the sixth. Kirsten Kaufman winds and fires. Bit outside, maybe trying to lure Barron into swinging at that one. 2-1.
A rare sight. Kaufman falls behind.
Barron able to make contact. Ball goes to Delator, who fires over to Steinmetz for the second out of the inning. Some pretty consistent play from the Blue Hens fielder so far. Only with 1 error charged against them so far today.
That was in
this second game.
I believe that was in the first inning from Gearhart, but other than that, she has really rebounded and played solid defense, as well as the whole team.
Hill comes up with the slap bunt kind of at bat and able to get herself over at first safely, as we saw. Her play in the field, too, the speed that she has is just something that you can't teach, and it's just something that she has that enables her to get on base.
And she is dangerous now that she's reached on base. Watch for a steal.
Howarth fouls the first one off behind the plate for strike one, 0-1 the count with 2 outs. Coffman winds and fires. As Emma Hill takes off her second, she's in there safe, as you mentioned, Jack. Very dangerous on the base path.
She has a knack for picking her pitches to steal on.
But fortunately for the Blue Hens, Coffman's ahead in the count 0-2 with 2 outs. as that one's fouled and out of play over by us, above our heads and to the left. Howarth stays active in this at-bat.
Howarth can be dangerous when runners are in scoring position, batting 375 as she bloops one.
Look, just foul there. Just to the left of the line. Fortunately for the Blue Hens. Howarth heads back to the batter's box. And Emma Hill, who had already crossed the plate with her speed, is back at second.
Coffman ahead 0-2 with two outs. Looking to just put this inning in the books.
Swung on and missed from Howarth. Kirsten Coffman gets her swinging to end the top of the sixth. We'll be right back with the bottom of the sixth inning.
Stay connected with the Blue Hens on all social media outlets. Follow at UD Blue Hens on Twitter for score updates, news, and everything Delaware sports. Check out at Hens All Access to see what it takes behind the scenes to bring you Delaware athletics. Interact with the University of Delaware Fightin' Blue Hens on Facebook to get to know the athletes and hear about events offered to Blue Hens fans. And take a look at UD Blue Hens on Instagram for game times, game finals, along with throwbacks of old Hens and promos for future Hens.
And a goal, it's Delgado with his second.
Anna Steinmetz looks to get things going for the Blue Hens here in the bottom of the sixth inning as she faces Sydney Underhill, who's been doing pretty well so far in today's game. Let up one run to the Blue Hens, and that's the only run on the board. Delaware clinging to the one-run lead so far.
But even the run that she did give up is unearned because of the error that was on the play. So really, both pitchers have remained dominant. I'm sure the Blue Hens are looking to pad their lead. Anna Steinmetz.
Steinmetz swings and hits one into left field where Howarth was there to make a play for out number one.
Howarth very active on the defensive front, coming in, going back, tracking balls to the side. She's a real defensive force to be reckoned with.
The left fielder and the center fielder, Howarth and Emma Hill, have been active in the two games today and have stood up to the challenges that they've faced so far. As Mariah Kondravy steps in for the Blue Hens and takes one for a ball. Swung on and missed the second pitch to even the count at 1-1. Underhill readies and fires. Kondravy back to the first baseman, Reyes, who's able to coast to first base and get the second out of the inning. Stashevitz sets a bat for the Blue Hens.
Underhill's just trying to get out of this inning so that she can allow her offense to get back into this game and try to get the one run that they need.
Stashevitz back to Wieserich, who goes over to Reyes at first to end the inning. Quick three outs there for the Blue Hens. And with that, we will catch you back at the top of the seventh inning.
Welcome. We have three Chevys here.
All right.
I want you to place this award on the podium next to the vehicle that you think was ranked highest in initial quality by J.D. Power. Hmm.
Can I look around at them?
Sure. Highest ranking in initial quality.
It's got to be this one.
This is it.
You are wrong.
Really?
Actually, it's all three.
You tricked me.
J.D. Power ranked the Chevy Malibu, Silverado Half Ton, and Equinox highest in initial quality in their segments.
That's impressive.
I'm very surprised.
I am. I'm very surprised. Debbie hit three home runs.
You can now watch all Hens All Access content on any of your devices. Whether you're at the store on your phone or on the couch with your iPad or laptop, Hens All Access live and on-demand content is just a touch away. Not only will live games be available on your mobile devices, they'll also be available in high definition. Best of all, you don't even need an app. Just click over to BlueHens.com on your device and take the Hens anywhere you go.
Kirsten Coffman looks to her teammates to help her finish out this game where they're ahead by one run, 1-0 against the Monmouth Hawks. The Hawks bringing up their 3, 4, and 5 hitters in the top of the 7th inning.
Coffman is going for her 5th complete game this season.
Fires that first pitch over for a strike.
Again, she is proving herself as the workhorse of this Delaware pitching staff and really setting the standard going forward.
Coffman fires another one outside. Count 1-1 to Rachel Schatzbarger, who's reached earlier in the 4th inning. Coffman throws one high there for ball 2. Looking to stay consistent with Coffman's pitching here in the top of the 7th to close things out for the Blue Hens to split the 2 games, as Schatzbarger fouls one high and away for strike 2. 2-2 the count.
Schatzbarger, only one of 2 players for the Monmouth team to record a hit today.
Ripped that one down the third baseline. Foul ball, fortunately for the Blue Hens.
Count remains 2-2.
Coffman takes a deep breath and heads back to the mound, looking to finish this at-bat off against Rachel Schatzbarger. She winds and fires. Swung on, hit deep to the gap in between Jones and George out in left center field as Schatzbarger strolls into second with a stand-up double.
She really got good contact on that one and drove that right in the gap between left and center. First baseman Reyes is now coming up, and she had a heck of a game earlier today, going 2-for-3 with a walk. So, looking to continue that streak, I'm sure she's going to try to drive in Schatzbarger.
Maybe a pinch runner coming in for Monmouth, as Nikki Sandelier, I believe, comes in for Schatzbarger. Running at second base.
Pitch running at second base for Monmouth, number 12, Nikki Sandelier.
Trying to put speed on this base path so that way they can hopefully get that last run or get the tying run in.
Sandelier with 2 stolen bases on 2 attempts so far this season, as Coffman gets Reyes to pop up to third baseman Lisa Stashevitz for out number 1 here in the top of the 7th inning. That's exactly what you needed if you're Kirsten Coffman. A quick out, not able to advance any runners, and just getting out on the board just like that.
Now hitting Ashlyn Umiyamaki, who grounded out and got out in her second at-bat as well, looking to drive in that second run, or the tying run on second base.
Kirsten Coffman offers a pitch. Umiyamaka flies out to right field, but advances Sandelier to third. 2 outs here in the top of the 7th with a runner on third for Jill Fries, who struck out twice so far today.
Designated player, number 13, Jill Fries.
Kirsten Coffman winds and fires. A foul ball that lands just on top of the press box for strike one. 0-1 the count here. Two outs. Runner on third.
Coffman just trying to regroup and finish this game out.
Coffman fires. Jill Freeze fouls it off for strike two. Coffman ahead in the count. 0-2 again. Looking for the third and final strike.
Freeze was on those last two pitches. So Coffman has to be careful here, even though she's in command with two strikes.
Coffman winds and fires high. And out of the strike zone for ball one. You saw Jill Freeze there offering bunt in the beginning of the windup for Coffman.
She does it again, offering as she draws back.
It's dangerous with how fast Coffman's been throwing the ball to offer bunt, pull it back, and try and get a swing through again. But that's what Freeze has been doing here so far in this at-bat.
It seems that it's a technique that she is comfortable with. So we'll see if she continues.
The 1-2 pitch swung on and fouled off yet again from Freeze. Staying alive in this at-bat. Coffman gets the sign, winds and fires. Swung on and missed from Jill Freeze. Her third strikeout of the game. Kirsten Coffman goes on to win this one. And the Blue Hens put up a great effort in the second game where they win 1-0.
That was an impressive pitching from Coffman. She records her first shutout of the season and her fifth complete game.
An incredible effort from both pitchers in today's game. Sydney Underhill and Kirsten Coffman able to keep this game low scoring and just keep most of the balls in the infield or easy fly balls to the outfield. And you saw Kirsten Coffman getting her third strikeout
on
the last batter there to end the game. So that will do it for us here at Delaware. The Delaware softball game versus Monmouth. Lost the first game 3-1, but came back and won the second game 1-0 to split the two-game doubleheader today.